again, from the community voice.
Editor-in-Chief Raven Cannon held an orientation for the first five vendors, all homeless or close to it, who will work for the paper.
I'm here doing I'm trying to find causes.
Jerome Freeman tells News 5 he's been on and off the streets.
Just know my stuff is okay.
He thinks the Springs Echo could be the opportunity our homeless community needs.
I don't care what the time is. If they change it, three or four guys have done it. But it'll be better. I'm going to help them.
Vendors get their first 10 papers for free. Each one after is 50 cents. So they pocket a dollar a copy at the suggested donation rate.
The community at large wants so desperately to see the homeless do something to help themselves. We keep hearing that we're doing that. And this is the homeless doing something to help themselves, so help me help them.
And the vendors are eager to get started.
Treat people with respect, do things in a professional manner, and try to get out and get these papers put on the streets.
That's what Richard Needham, or Worm as he's known on the streets, takes away from the orientation.
Well, it might actually bring people's awareness to some of the everyday struggles that we go through being homeless. And there's actually a lot of really good people that don't do anything wrong out here on the streets from actions that aren't even their own fault.
And the paper has a board of directors and is also going through the paperwork to become a nonprofit. If you want to pick up one of these issues, like I said, you can find it first issue, New Year's Day, and then every beginning of the month after that, they'll have another issue out down here. So just look downtown for the vendors. In downtown, watching out for you, Ted Strobeck, News 5.